LG is hoping you forget all about the modular disaster that was the LG G5 with its new LG G6. This is your early hands-on first look. Now, the first thing you're going to notice about the G6 is obviously the display. The phone is practically all display. It's got a giant 5.7-inch 18:9 aspect ratio display. The thing is practically all display. It's only got these tiny little bezels at the top and bottom. But because the display is so tall and narrow and the bezels are so small, it's actually not really any bigger than a 5.5-inch phone and kind of narrower, so it's really pretty easy to hold and use. It's also the first phone display that I've ever seen that will support HDR content with HDR10 and Dolby Vision support. Moving around the back, it's got two cameras, just like LG's phone did last year, a wide-angle lens and a regular angle lens. But last year, the wide-angle lens was kind of an afterthought. It was a lower resolution, worse sensor than the regular angle one. This time, they've got the same 13-megapixel sensor for both cameras, so you can use either one and get the same great quality. It's got a Qualcomm Snapdragon 821 processor, 4 gigs of RAM, 32 gigs of storage, and support for SD cards, but it does not have a removable battery. LG did that because they wanted to make it waterproof this time, and it's really hard to make it waterproof and have a battery compartment you can open. But it is IP68 water resistant, which means it can resist water for up to 30 minutes in a meter and a half of water, which is great. USB Type-C, which we're expect to see on most phones these days, and support for Qualcomm's Quick Charge 3.0 technology. LG also made a really big deal about the reliability of their phone. They're really hammering on all those Note 7s that exploded last year, I guess. But they wanted to make sure that you knew that they've done all kinds of drop testing, they've done puncture testing on the battery, tweaks to the charge cycle. When you charge it up, you're not weakening the battery over time so it doesn't hold as much charge. They really want you to feel like this is a phone that you can buy and it's not gonna be a broken mess in just a year. In Hong Kong and Korea and a couple other Asian markets, you get better audio output. You get the quad DAC like they had in the LG V20 last year. But you don't get that in Europe or US or anywhere else. And in the US, you get wireless charging, support for PMA and Qi wireless charging technologies, both, but you don't get those anywhere else in the world. So where you buy the phone is going to make a difference in the specs you get. There's nowhere you can go and just get all that goodness. And that's kind of a bummer. So what do we think of the phone so far? Well, LG is definitely going a lot less gimmicky than they have in the past with the modular thing and everything. The 18:9 aspect ratio is unique and it's gonna take a little bit of getting used to, but we're gonna see it on some other phones this year too. Other than that, it's not really got any one thing that makes it stand out. We're used to seeing dual cameras. We're used to seeing, you know, great displays. We're used to waterproofing. We're used to Snapdragon A21. All of these things are things that we have in phones today. So it's really gonna come down to what is the experience like using it? Is it fast? Is it fluid? Does it do the things you really want it to do?